Hi friends, today I am going to show you Pentool in Photoshop. This tool will help you to create any custom shape, path to write text on that path, right? To fill that path, make a nice stroke on that path. So let's jump to Photoshop and I'll show you how to handle the bezier handles in Photoshop. To access the Pentool, you just need to click on this icon where you see a fountain pen like icon out here. Or what you can do is press letter P. To make a path, we need at least 2 points that we have learned in our preliminary maths class, where to create a straight line, you need to have 2 points, right? 1 point and 2 points. So this creates a path, a straight line. Suppose if you want to create something, anything, suppose like for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is also a path which is called an open path. I'll show you how to give it a stroke on this path and all in a very short period of time. Let's see what else you can do. Basically, people fear to touch this tool, Pentool, because they get these weird shapes when they want to create something like this. Usually, I too used to face this kind of issues when I was learning Photoshop. But the trick which I am going to show you right now will help you a lot in controlling this handles, which is called bezier handle, right? So let me clear off the screen, and with an example I'll show you how to create a complex shape. Let's choose any complex shape right from here. Suppose let me choose something. Okay, let me choose this. If you want to create something, a tick mark. By the way, I am pressing Ctrl and Shift to constrain and give it a perfect shape. Suppose if you want to make something like this and you don't have this shape in your custom shape. It's a very basic thing. What you have to do is you have to select Pentool and start giving a basic shape. Don't worry about this jagged, unwanted kind of shape that's been formed. You got a basic shape. Now what you have to do is, like, inside the Pentool menu, you have a tool. You see an icon out here, just press it, keep pressing, and you get a drawer where you have other tools, like for example convert tool, delete anchor tool, anchor point tool, add anchor point tool, freeform pen tool. So we will take this convert point tool and start creating a curve. When you leave this and when you come back, you see already the bezier handle has been broken. By the way, I'll show you another trick where, with the help of that particular key combination, you can get your convert point tool plus pen tool. So now what you got your basic shape. You can get this convert point tool by pressing Alt key. Now you see, when I press Alt key and when I move towards the point, you get the point converted, right? Else you'll get this delete anchor point, this one, right? By default you'll get that thing. So when I click, it gets deleted. I'm doing Ctrl Z to come back, right? Let me be on a pen tool, and by pressing Alt we get this tool called convert point tool. Another tool we can use is called a direct selection tool. That too can be accessed by pressing Ctrl on the keyboard. Now I am in pen tool. While pressing Ctrl key, I get a direct selection tool. With this direct selection tool, what I can do is I can move any point. I'm just selecting this point by Ctrl dragging it and I'm started moving it. Now you can understand. And with the help of Alt tool, I'm converting the point, right? Are you getting my point? I hope you got a basic idea. Now, just to make this as a shape, you do the same way. Where this, you don't have to worry about this, we can take care of it. I have not left my Alt key, right? With the direction selection tool, I am just adjusting my points so that it matches with this particular thing. Right. So somewhat we got this, a nice tick mark shape. Right. So what did we see today? We saw basically three tools will help you to create your custom shape. First was your pen tool. Second was convert anchor tool. Convert point tool, sorry. And the third one was direct selection tool. So with these three tools, we can create any custom shape, any custom shape. I hope I have given you a clear view of how to access the pen tool, how to use the pen tool, how to make a curve with the help of convert point tool, and with the direct selection tool we can handle the points to make a nice custom shape. Thank you guys. We'll see in the next lecture.